Oh, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Belton, Texas. How are you tonight on a 4th of July weekend? Oh, you're looking good. We wore red tonight. I said, you know, it's patriotism. It's our country. It's the red, white, and blue. And nobody does it any better than Belton, Texas. 86 consecutive years of a celebration here. And tonight, big time rodeo. And our guests and contestants from 15 different states, Australia and Canada. It's truly international. I'm Charlie Throckmorton. Nice to be back again in the Coliseum and around. And tonight, it is a great, great performance and a lot of electricity in the air tonight. I just have one question for you. Are you proud to be an American on America's birthday? Me too. You know, folks, there's a lot of history here at Belton. It's the site of the Chisholm Trail. And a lot of things have happened down through the years. And of course, our neighbors over to Fort Hood, the United States military, the men and women that keep our freedom strong, and patriotism. But right now, as I get your attention, I ask for your heart, your mind, and an ear. And let's stroll back through time in history of the very first Americans that pioneered this country. I think you will enjoy. Watch tonight. Well, the very first American was a Native American, the Indian. The Indian was a true pioneer, the very first American of them all. For the Indian loved the land, never taking more than what he needed. And with the independence and the courage, like the buffalo he hunted, the Indian thrived. Men with braided hair, high cheekbones, expressions that were penetrating, and faces that were fearless. Images of a painted horseman, the fierce warrior. There were many tribes in Texas. However, the most feared throughout the white settlers in this area were the Comanche Indians. You're looking at one right now, full-blood Comanche. The Comanches led many raids through central Texas, fought several battles. The Indian was a warrior with pride, for his message rang loud and clear. We are free people, free to roam, free to live off the land. But in the 1800s, there was bloodshed, and then there was war. How about a hand for the American Indian tonight, if you would? Then came the cowboy, the pioneer who braved the wilderness, not knowing its hazards of forbidding mountains and arid deserts. But the cowboy came in thousands, and sometimes many took what he wanted, sometimes land claimed by the Comanche. Oh, but nothing would stand in his way. He was always pushing west, wanting more. And with that movement west, there was war. There was conflicts and broken treaties, bloodshed and boundaries. It was the red man and the white man, each to stand his ground. Would war ever stop? Well, ladies and gentlemen, tonight we do not point a finger at who was wrong or right. For these two men were both Americans and a part of our history of the American West. And after many struggles and sacrifices, they lower their rifles and through time have learned to live together. And together is one, to live in peace, both national symbols. And tonight, to overlook what differences that may have occurred, to extend a hand of friendship and of trust and one of liberty. And like the eagle, to remain free in the greatest country in the world, the United States of America. sometimes swollen rivers. And the cattle drives had to cross it. And the great Texas Longhorns, the Chisholm Trail. Are they gorgeous? For Belton sits directly on the famous Chisholm Trail, where the thousands of cattle were driven to the major railheads north. They started in the year of 1867. Texas Longhorn cattle had the perseverance, the stamina to survive. They were about as tough as the Texas cowboys that drove them. Thousands of head of cattle driven 10, 15, 20 miles a day through all kinds of weather and to accomplish the impossible, to achieve commerce and trade and settle the wild frontier. Tonight we pay tribute to them here on America's birthday. How about a hand for the cowboy and the cattle driver? Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, it's a tribute as well to family and the foundation of our country. And the cowboy who nurtured the land, the farmer and the ranchers, and even in the modern era that worked from sunup to sundown. They're still independent and they're brutally honest and they stand for respect and tradition and values. These men do work that others wouldn't do. They fix a water gap and mosquitoes, and they ride all day till they're galded and the inside of their knees are raw, but they endure. The old cowboy probably couldn't tell you the bestseller on the New York Times list, but he can quote the Bible. He's not aware of Hollywood's top-grossing movie, yet he's seen Lonesome Dove. Now what about the cowgirl, the wife, the lady? She does her part. She works just as hard and never asks for any thanks, for she knows she's loved. She prepares the meals, gets the kids ready for school, and at times starches and irons their clothes. For the kids of the farms and ranches have pride in the way they look. You'll never see baggy pants hanging down on their butts on these kids. It ain't done here in Texas. For this is the foundation I'm talking about. This is family. They are the Western image and the best of what this country is all about. How about a hand for family tonight in Belton? And then, on this 4th of July weekend, on America's birthday, join with me as we salute the American soldier. For the United States fighting forces perpetuate freedom. And the soldier knows very well that freedom does not come free. The soldier is sometimes an ordinary person. They're just capable of extraordinary things. Men and women of uncommon valor. And each one could be your brother, your sister, your mother, your father. A family member that loves this country, and they love it enough to die for it. And make no mistake about it, they do it in a country with a flag that represents a nation under God. Tonight, if you get a cold, Cheryl, or a tear to your eye, you'll never have a more worthy emotion. That simply means you're an American. We take a lot of pride in what we do. God bless the USA. And then there's the good Lord above. Our Heavenly Father, we pause in the midst of this festive occasion this evening to pay tribute to faith in our country, what we're all about, Lord. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the troops that landed in Fort Hood today, for the service they have done to their country, and they'll continue to do so. Through these history, our Father, the American Indian, the Cowboys, the Pioneers, through their honest toil and a spirit in harmony, we come together tonight to join hands. Lord, we don't care what creed or color or where you come from, but to enjoy peace on America's birthday. It's been a good run, Lord, for 86 years here. We give thanks for those things in which we have tonight, and never pray for those things in which we want. But a better future for our kids ahead, to live in peace, and the whole world would be a part of utopia. I just say thank you, Lord. And in Jesus Christ's name we pray, amen. It is a special time tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Let's join in song for the playing of our Star Spangled Banner, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still
what it's all about.
R-O-C-K in the USA.
Born in the USA tonight.
R-O-C-K.